Welcome back, students. Now let us start our first chapter. So before starting the chapter, let us have a look at the contents of the chapter. The topics that we will cover in this chapter are matter, characteristics of particles of matter. Third is states of matter. Fourth, change of state of matter. Fifth one, latent heat. And the last one, evaporation and its effects. So these are the topics that we will cover in this chapter, and hope I will be able to make you understand our chapter with the first topic, that is matter. So what is matter? Anything which occupies space, which occupies space and have mass. So anything which occupies space and have mass, it is called matter. Like wall, rocks, stone, iron, copper, milk, tea, these all things are matter because they are occupying space. They are occupying space and having mass. But those things which does not occupy space, and does not have mass, they are not called matter. Those things which does not occupy space and does not have mass, they are not called matter. Example, our ideas, thoughts, emotions, anger, fear, anxiety, these all things does not occupy any space. They does not occupy space and does not have mass. That's why these are not considered as matter. Now, classification of matter. Matter can be classified into two ways. First is on the basis of their physical properties. And second is on the basis of their chemical properties. First is on the basis of their physical properties, and second is on the basis of their chemical properties. On the basis of physical properties, matter can be classified into three types. That are solid, liquid, and gases. So matter can be classified into three types on the basis of their physical properties. And on the basis of chemical properties, it can again be classified into three types. Those three types are elements, compounds, and mixtures. In this chapter, we will read about the classification of matter on the basis of their physical properties, that is solid, liquids, and gases, and on the basis of chemical properties, that is elements, compounds, and mixture, we will read in the next chapter. Now the next topic is matter is made up of particles. Everything around us is made up of particles, like our body, fan, table, chair, this board, this marker, everything is made up of particles. and the number of particles. The number of particles and everything is very very large. The number of particles and everything is very very large. For example, a raindrop. It is made up of 10 raised to power 21 particles. It is made up of 10 raised to power 21 particles. And the size of these particles are very very small. The size of these particles is very very small. Very very small. Though we cannot see these particles, but there are certain evidences, which shows that the particles are very very small in size. They are very very small in size. Even if we use a most powerful microscope, then also we can't see these particles. For viewing these particles, we need an electron microscope. And these particles are either called atoms or molecules. So basically what we read, everything that is around us or we also are made up of particles, and the number of particles in everything is very very large. Like for an example, a raindrop is made up of 10 raised to power 21 particles. And the size of the particles is very very small. And we can't see them with the powerful microscope also. We need an electron microscope. And these particles are either atoms or molecules. This we will read in the third chapter.